Good morning and God bless you. We're delighted to have you all with us here this morning. Maybe this is your first time tuning in and joining us. We extend a warm welcome to you and trust you're blessed with what you hear today. We want to begin with prayer. Want to continue to pray about the condition and the direction of our nation. We also want to remember our local community and region. The door is squeaking open. Door of utterance. We also want to pray for Cornerstone Pentecostal Church and lastly, our brothers and sisters around the world. Maybe you have a special unspoken request. It's a perfect time to make that known unto God. Why don't we pray together? Father, we love you. We praise you. We worship you. We thank you for the abundance of all things that are so freely given unto us. Father, we pray about the condition and the direction of our nation. We pray for a genuine move of the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. We also pray for a door of utterance to be opened that will give us an opportunity to influence and to communicate with our local region here and beyond. We also pray for Cornerstone Pentecostal Church and pray that you'll open up the windows of heaven and pour out your favor and your blessing. And lastly, our brothers and sisters around the world, we pray that you provide each and every one of them with a hedge of protection. Everyone said, in the name of Jesus. Well, I started a series couple days ago, and I'm still working on part two because we want it to be informative, have substance and qualitative. But I feel something more immediate that I want to talk to us about. And I want to go to Hebrews chapter number 10, an incredibly powerful and potent chapter in the Word of God, one verse of Scripture, Hebrews chapter 10, verse number 32, but call to remembrance the former days in which after you were illuminated, ye endured a great fight of afflictions, but call to remembrance the former days. Hebrews chapter 10 is wide and long and deep, and by no means am I going to tackle that in this devotional here this morning. But while I was praying and meditating this morning, this verse of Scripture, but call to remembrance the former days. I want to lift that verse and that very first sentence of that verse, and I want to talk to us about back to the basics. Back to the basics. Being a first generation apostolic is both exhilarating, it's glorious, it is mind-boggling that I have been called out of darkness to be a part of this. I just love it. But I have an incredible appreciation, more all the time, about a multi-generational history that some families enjoy in the apostolic movement. I am not envious and I am not jealous in a negative or evil sense. But I have a great appreciation for that. And my beautiful wife and I have started our own heritage together. We have children and grandchildren right here at Cornerstone. And it's a wonderful and powerful thing. When I hear some of my elders talk about the early days, I love hearing about the early days of Pentecost and this apostolic movement. I just do. I have a great, great appreciation, admiration, and love for the early days. And I just can't get enough of it. I love to hear elders and older sisters just talk about how they came in contact with truth and what it was like going to church and what life was like and what just everything about it. I'm just fascinated with it. I love it. I have a great appreciation for it. And one of the things that I admire about it is the simplicity that early Pentecostalism and this wonderful apostolic movement, the simplicity of their lives. I know that there was things going on, you know, I'm going somewhere with this, and so I don't want to talk too much about where I'm going with this now, but I want to say that there were, when you hear about the simplicity and just the prayer and the living for God and the revival and the miracles and the relationship with Jesus and the joy and the power, the continuity, the supernatural continuity of all that. And the joy that was with that. I have never heard anybody that has talked about the early days. I've never heard them complain that they were missing out from something in this world. I never heard anybody complain that they were missing out from what was going on in Hollywood. And when you're talking about going back, you know, 60s, the 50s, the 40s, and even beyond that, it was still there. The world is the world, and the world was still there, and fleshly pleasures were still there, and the devil was still the devil, and the world was still the world, and the flesh is still the flesh. But I've never heard anybody, and there's some people that go back generations that when they talk, I'm all ears. And I've never heard anybody complain or whine around or feel like they were shortchanged by not being involved with the world. It was the early days of the apostolic movement and the beauty of simplicity. It was living for God without being propped up, no filler, no. I'll live for God, but I got to have this. It was pure. It was gun barrel straight. With that as our foundation, this is really where I want to go. Let's fast forward that into the 21st century, August of 2023. On any given service, and I'm not being critical, I'm just saying on any given service, I can look out there and see people on their iPhones. We have politely asked people to turn their iPhones off unless it's emergency. You have caretakers. We have caretakers in our congregation. I understand all that for emergency purposes. There has to be that. But I'm just saying, here we are in the 21st century, and you've got iPhones, you have a plethora of dynamics of people that are living in this hour, that the short amount of time that we are together as a body, we absolutely, it is critical, ladies and gentlemen, that all of us begin with prayer. I mean, that is the starting point of really having good church. And I'm not here to bash anybody I'm not out to get anybody. I really have a desire to get back to the basics as a people, where it starts in the prayer room and we've all become adjusted because we've tagged in and we've aligned ourselves afresh. And that carries over into the worship and the praise. And there is a liberation, and there is a spontaneous joy, and there's an empowerment and a glory and a blessing. And then we're all waiting and expecting and anticipating the Word of God, which is the centerpiece of the service, is that receiving the Word of God and we're on our feet and we're amening and we're getting into the preaching and we're behind the ministry that's giving the Word of God. And then there is the culmination of it all, and it comes down to that altar call, and everybody is captivated and we're all moved by the centrifugal force of the Spirit, and we're all brought to that place of the altar call. Healing over here and praying through over here and salvation. Someone's getting baptized and a person receiving the Holy Ghost. That is everything. That is everything. And I don't know how much longer the Lord is going to tarry. We're seeing things that have never on the face of the planet, as long as humanity has ever existed on the face of this planet, this generation is being exposed to things that has never been proposed. And technology is available to all, and this and that and this and that, and ladies and gentlemen, I am a crusader today. It's time to go back to the basics, living by faith, having a prayer life, having healthy, godly relationships with the body that are joyous and purpose filled, and that you can feel that tangible divine connection with brothers and sisters in the body of Christ. I was raised that way. That is exactly how I interpreted my spiritual upbringing. It was, yes, there were afflictions, and yes, there were trials, and yes, the devil's after me, yes, my flesh is after me, yeah, all that stuff. It's always been there. It's always been that way. But getting back to the basics and truly living for God, I am a crusader for that. I wanted to talk to you about this because that's where we're headed. That's where we're headed. And that's really what it's all about. I'm not saying that you need to flush your iPhone down the toilet. Maybe some people do. If you can't control it, make no mistake about it, it is controlling you. And it is a major epidemic in this culture. Make no mistake about it. Social media, technological advancement in your hand. This is 10 times more powerful than the most powerful home computer 20 years ago, what you're holding in your hands. I mean, it is absolutely that advanced. But there is a call. There is a call to get back to the basics. Let's do it. In Jesus' name. God bless you. Thank you for joining us here this morning. Have a great rest of your day. God bless you. Thank you.